a light like a tide on a beach. Poetry, talent coming in. It's wonderful. So we're just extending the first half slightly. Got something else? Not to worry. Okay, moving on. Another regular attender at Inkwell, award-winning poet. Woo! Thank you. Right, give her a big welcome, please, Hannah Stone. Yay.
Some rude words already because I've got a rude word on one of my phones, so I know it doesn't matter. I've been helping to look after an elderly friend of mine who's 86, and a couple of days ago they were proposing to send her out of hospital back home with a leg in a splint and no care package in place, and they said they were going to get the Red Cross to come and give her a hand. So I asked them to think again. Care in the community. She rests in her narrow bed, kindly made up by a friend who isn't that good at hospital corners. Sometimes she sleeps deeply under the faded gaze of her lord. Other nights she's restless, wishes she was safe as a crinolined lady it takes her half an hour to dust. China knickknacks have a secure place on the mantelpiece. And if stiff fingers were to drop a treasure on the hearth, oblivion is instantaneous. No rehab ward for shattered shepherdesses. No waiting for the thud of skull on path as she stoops with the milk bottles. No fear of falling. Thank you. I gather that it comes to a certain point when elderly people have fallen once or twice and injured themselves, that their biggest fear every waking moment is that they're going to fall over again.
Yeah.
And that's how it is for her. I was very fortunate recently to be able to travel a couple of times, and I spent a fair bit of time at Manchester Airport, and I was going around all these shops they have once they've taken all your details and checked all your possessions. I came across this... marketing tag, which I just really stuck in my throat, and this is from Fat Face, and they said, "We proudly make clothes that reflect," and then they go into a bigger font, "happy, healthy lifestyles of our customers." And I thought, okay, so what do you do for all the rest of us? So this is called rebranding. Here's a brand for the rest of us, the insecure, the anxious. For those of us not feeling breezy, with nicotine addictions or cellulite, who frankly couldn't give a toss about hanging hero pieces on the rail. For those of us who's built to last means garments that we've worn for 20 years, the clothes with pockets patched as our lives, threadbare as false hope, but they do the job. For those of us whose big hearts find quiet ways to stay beside the friend who feels forgotten, whose fears and lethargy don't make great Facebook postings. Let's call this new brand Work in Progress, Focus, Accepting Yourself. Objective, giving half a shit about some things that really count. So shrug on your shabby shirt and go and vote the fuckers out.